Hello everyone, today we will see what is an always block and how an always block is used in Verilog. So far I have covered data flow modeling technique, gate flow modeling technique, then how to write Verilog code for structural modeling and behavioral modeling technique. So today we will learn how this always block is used in Verilog. So before that, let's learn what is a procedural block. As we all know that behavioral level is the highest level of abstraction. That is what I have discussed during the behavioral modeling technique, that behavioral level is the highest level of abstraction and the lowest level of abstraction is gate flow modeling technique. Okay. So, and whenever we write a behavioral code, the synthesis tool may not generate a optimal logic, means it may not be synthesizable one. So if I write something behavioral, then my synthesis tool may not generate a logic that will be optimal in terms of speed or area. Okay. And so it may not be a synthesizable one. So what I can say is the behavioral code or behavioral modeling may not be a synthesizable one, but this behavioral modeling technique is very, very powerful and it is mostly used during RTL verification or writing test bench to test the functionality of our design. So during the RTL verification, or when we want to test our design using the test, writing test cases, and we write the test bench to design our logic, that time normally we use behavioral modeling technique or behavioral code mostly we use. So this is a very powerful technique, we can say, in Verilog. And this Verilog restricts all the behavioral statements. Okay, so whatever statements we write during the behavioral modeling, Verilog restricts all the behavioral statements to be enclosed in a procedural block. Means the behavioral statements are written inside a procedural block. Okay, so what is a procedural block? Whatever we write for a behavioral modeling, it is enclosed inside a block, and that is called a procedural block. So suppose if I am writing a Verilog code for a particular logic or particular design, then whatever statements I write inside a block is called procedural block. In a procedural block, all variable on the left hand sides are declared as range. Means if I write here A equal to B during my behavioral modeling technique, then this A, this is my left side, this is my right side. So this variable A has to be a range one, and this right side variable B has to be either range or either wire. That you have to remember, and it is very important. The left hand side inside a procedural block has to be a net range type, and the right hand side has to be a range or wire type. Okay. So there are two types of procedural block. One is always, another is initial. So Verilog provides two type of procedural block. One is always, another is initial. Procedural block is basically begin, end, and body of the code in between. So that is what, see, this bracket I have given here. So it is like begin, then end. Okay. Then whatever write inside this begin and end, this block is called procedural block, and the statements that I write here is the procedural statement, we can say. So whatever I write inside the begin and end, it is called the procedural statement, and including the begin and end part is called procedural block. And the statements that we write inside a procedural block is executed कंटिन्यूअसली, दिस वन इज एग्जीक्यूटेड कंटिन्यूअसली अनलेस एंड अनटिल, ओके, मीन्स विद इन द ऑलवेज ब्लॉक. सपोज इफ आई हैव ऑलवेज ब्लॉक, दिस इज माई ऑलवेज ब्लॉक एंड सम स्टेटमेंट्स आई हैव रिटन हेयर, इट इज एग्जीक्यूटेड कंटिन्यूअसली अनलेस एंड अनटिल इट इज स्टॉप्ड बाय ए टाइम ब्लॉक डिले. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड टाइम ब्लॉक डिले. दिस एट द रेट हैश और वेट, ऑल दीज कंस्ट्रक्ट्स आर कॉल्ड टाइम ब्लॉक डिले. सो अनलेस एंड अनटिल द वेरिलॉग कोड व्हाट एवर इज रिटन एनकाउंटर्स ऑल दीज कंस्ट्रक्ट्स, द टाइम डिले लाइक एट द रेट हैश और वेट इज एनकाउंटर्ड दिस पार्ट दिस प्रोसीजरल ब्लॉक और इनसाइड द ऑलवेज व्हाट एवर इज रिटन इज एग्जीक्यूटेड कंटिन्यूअसली, दैट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर, ओके. एंड द प्रोसीजरल ब्लॉक कंटेन वन और मोर स्टेटमेंट्स. सो इनसाइड दिस प्रोसीजरल ब्लॉक वी कैन हैव वन स्टेटमेंट और वी कैन हैव मोर देन वन स्टेटमेंट और द असाइनमेंट्स दैट वी डू इनसाइड दिस प्रोसीजरल ब्लॉक. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई राइट ए इक्वल टू बी, ओके, so this is my assignment. I am assigning the value of b to variable a. So whatever assignments we do inside the procedural block is called procedural assignment. So this is a procedural assignment. Whatever assignments we do inside the procedural block is called procedural assignment. And this procedural assignments is of two types, okay. And this procedural assignment is of two type. One is blocking and another is non-blocking assignment. That we will learn later. So you have to remember there are two type of procedural assignment. One is blocking and another is non-blocking. Okay. So what we covered is behavioral is the highest level of abstraction. Then the left-hand side inside the procedural block has to be a RAGE net type. And then right hand side has to be either RAGE or either WHERE. There are two type of procedural block. One is always, another is initial. Then inside a procedural block, whatever statement we write, we always write inside the begin and end. Okay. And this always block, that is what you call the procedural block, is executed continuously. It runs continuously by the simulator unless and until we encountered a time delay at the rate hash or wait. And whatever the assignment we do inside a procedural block is called procedural assignment. It is of two types. One is called blocking assignment, another is non-blocking assignment. Okay. So let's learn what is a always block. Always block is a procedural block in Verilog. And procedural statements are specified inside always block. Okay. So this is my always. Then whatever I write inside the always block. So this always is a procedural block. Okay. So whatever I write inside the always block are the procedural statements. Then an always block indicates a set of procedural instruction that happen in order they are written. So the way it is written, in the order that it is written, the same way it is executed. Means if it is written first, second, then third statements, then all these statements are executed as the way it is written. Okay. All the statements inside always block is executed sequentially. Okay. So that is what these procedural instructions are. Means all these statements are executed sequentially, or we can say procedurally, you can say. So all the statements inside always block is executed sequentially. So one by one, all the statements, first this, suppose this is the first statement, this is the second statement, this is the third statement. So the first statement will be executed first, then the second statement will be executed, then the third statement will be executed inside the always block. An always block is synthesizable provided coding guidelines for synthesis are followed. So whatever we write inside this always block, it may be synthesizable, it may not be synthesizable. Okay. It will be synthesizable only if we follow the coding guidelines. ओके देयर आर सम कोडिंग गाइडलाइंस आर देयर फॉर फॉर द फॉर योर कोड टू बी सिंथेसाइजेबल एंड इफ वी फॉलो दैट कोडिंग गाइडलाइंस एंड इफ वी राइट द कोड देन ओनली दिस वॉट एवर इज रिटन इन साइड द ऑलवेज ब्लॉक विल बी ऑलवेज सिंथेसाइजेबल एल्स इट मे नॉट बी सिंथेसाइजेबल ओके सो द वॉट एवर वी राइट इन साइड ऑलवेज ब्लॉक मे बी सिंथेसाइजेबल मे नॉट बी सिंथेसाइजेबल दैट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर एंड वॉट इज द सिंटैक्स ऑफ ऑलवेज ब्लॉक द दिस इज द सिंटैक्स ऑफ ऑलवेज ब्लॉक फर्स्ट इज द ऑलवेज कीवर्ड देन एट द रेट देन पैरेंथिसिस ओके दिस पैरेंथिसिस देन इन साइड सम इवेंट ओके और वी कैन से दिस इवेंट आर सेंसिटिव दिस इवेंट्स आर कॉल्ड सेंसिटिविटी लिस्ट ओके दिस इज नॉट ए कीवर्ड ओके यू विल गेट टू नो व्हाट इज दिस इवेंट सो सिंटैक्स इज फर्स्ट ऑलवेज कीवर्ड देन एट द रेट देन पैरेंथिसिस एंड इन साइड द पैरेंथिसिस देयर विल बी सेंसिटिविटी लिस्ट ओके देन procedural statements are there as already discussed so we can have more than one statement we can have two we can have three we can have any number of statements and it is inside the begin and end so as we know that this in procedural block we write begin and inside whatever is there is called the procedural statements and this is the procedural block so this part is 1 minute So we can say this part is procedural block. Okay. So this is your procedural block. And these are your procedural statements. Okay. That we have to remember. So this is the syntax. This always block can be used for both combinational and sequential logic design. Okay. So if you want to design your logic for a combinational circuit or a sequential circuit it can be used the always block can be used so it is used for both combinational or sequential logic design if we do not provide any sensitivity list then always block runs continuously so in this syntax we can say if there is no sensitivity list we do not mention anything inside the parenthesis or there is no parenthesis we can say then these statements runs continuously Okay, if there is no sensitivity list mentioned here, then all these statements, whatever the statements inside the always block, will run continuously. That you have to remember. When any signal in sensitivity list changes, always block is activated and executes the statements. So, if there is a changes in sensitivity list, if I mention some signal here inside the sensitivity list so if there is a changes in sensitivity list then this part will be executed and evaluated okay that I will show you through example okay this at the rate is called event control directives okay this at the rate you have to remember it is a event control directives it halts the execution of statements until the event happens that is listed inside at the rate parenthesis okay so if there is no changes so if there is no changes inside whatever we write in the sensitivity list if there is no changes in the sensitivity list then it halts the execution so the statements written inside this always block won't be executed unless and until there is a changes in this part there is a changes in this sensitivity list okay let me give you one example range variable x and y so this is my procedural statement okay this is my procedural statement always at the rate a or b so syntax was always then at the rate then inside the parenthesis I have written a or b or I can also write this a or b equals to I can also write a comma b so this a and b signals are now the sensitivity list we can say this one the sensitivity list we can say now the sensitivity inside the sensitivity list I have the signal a and b so if there is any changes in a or b okay so if there will be any changes in a and b this part this whatever is written inside the begin and end part will be evaluated and it will be executed so if a changes either a changes or b changes either both changes or either a changes or either b changes then it will enter into the inside this begin and end, then this part will be evaluated and this will be assigned to x, this part will be evaluated, this right hand part will be evaluated and this will be assigned to y. But there has to be a changes in a or b. If there is, so this statement is what it is saying. When any signal in sensitivity list changes, always block is activated and executes the statements. So if there is a changes in a or b, then this part will be, so this always block will be activated and whatever is written inside this always block, the right hand part will be evaluated and it will be assigned to x. This will be assigned to this left hand side. Okay, and if there is no changes, for example this statement, it halts the execution of statements until the event happens. So if the event happens means if there is no changes in the sensitivity list, then this always block won't be activated. It won't be activated and there won't be any kind of assignment there won't be any kind of execution of the statements that is written inside the begin and end. Okay, so these are called procedural statements, right? This is called sensitivity list. These are called procedural statements. This x equal to a plus b if I write. So this is a procedural statements. So whenever a or b changes, this block is executed. This whole block is executed. Okay, so if a or b changes, then this right hand part will be executed and it will be assigned to x. And if there is changes in a or b, this will be evaluated, then it will be assigned to y. Okay, so multiple statements, if see I have how many statements here, I have here two statements, x equal to a plus b and y equal to a plus b. I have two statements. If there is if there are more than one statement, then I can enclose that statement inside begin and end. But if I have only one statement, suppose if I have only x equal to a plus b, then I don't need to include begin and end. Without begin and end also, it will work. It won't show any error. But if I have more than one statement, then we should include begin and end. Okay. And this is pure combinational lie, right? So this is what it is written. Always block can be used for both combinational and sequential logic design. So x equal to a plus b is nothing but this is OR gate. This is A, this is B, and this is X. So this is pure combinational logic. So what we are doing here, we are implementing a combinational logic inside a always block. So this can be used for combinational, this can be used for sequential logic. If I write always clock equal to not of clock, it runs forever if clock signal is given once. What does it mean? See, if there is no sensitivity list, what we saw here, so if there is no sensitivity list, whatever we write inside this always block, it runs continuously. That is what we saw, right? 1 minute. See, once started, the simulator will procedural execute all the code within the always block unless it is stopped by time block delay. So here I have not included any sensitivity list. So as there is no sensitivity list, so this statement will run forever. It won't stop because there is no sensitivity list. It halts the execution of statements until the event happens. So there is no event because there is no sensitivity list. So there is no event is going to happen. So it runs forever. Okay, it runs continuously. So there will be clock. Then once I give clock signal, suppose 0, then it will be inverted 1, then 0, then 1, then 0, then 1, then. So it runs continuously. It runs forever. Okay, this is what this statement is all about. It runs forever if clock signal is given once. Okay. Always at the rate pause edge of clock q equal to d in. So what I am doing here, when there is a changes in clock, pause edge of clock means this pause edge, this is the positive edge, this is the positive edge of clock. So if there is a positive clock is encountered, Then this input part, the D in part is assigned to Q. This is nothing but a D flip flop, right? In D flip flop, what happens? So this is my clock and this is my D in and this is my output. So whenever there is a positive clock, so if your logic encounters this positive clock, this positive clock means positive edge of clock, then whatever is there in D in before that positive edge, whatever is there in D in, that D in will be transferred, we can say, or it will be assigned to, or it will be transferred to the output Q. So this is a D flip flop, always at the red positive edge of clock. So at the positive edge of clock, if there is a changes in clock, then this right hand part will be assigned to left hand part, and this is a D flip flop, and D flip flop is nothing but a sequential logic, and that is what this statement is saying. Always block can be used for combinational or sequential. So here we saw that this always block is used for combinational logic. Okay, this is combinational logic, but here what we saw here is this always block is used for sequential logic. So now we are sure that always block can be used for combinational or can be used for sequential logic. Okay. A single module can have multiple number of always procedural block and they run simultaneously at time zero. However, it depends on the simulator. So inside a module, if I write a Verilog code, inside a module, this is module and module. Okay. I can have any number of always block. Okay, I can have one, I can have two, I can any number of always block as per my requirement. Okay, so a single module can have multiple number of always procedural block and they run simultaneously at time zero. So as all these are independent, this always block is independent, this is independent, this is independent, they run independently, they don't depend on this always block, don't depend on this rest of the always block. So all these always block runs independently and they runs continuously at zero simulation time. So whenever your simulator starts or your simulation starts, so at 0 second or 0 nanosecond or zero time this block is executed at zero time. Okay, it is not like that first this block will executed, then this block is first, this block is second, this block is third. Doesn't mean first this block will be executed, then this will be executed, then this will be executed. No, all these blocks, whatever is written inside the module, will be executed simultaneously at time equal to zero. So whenever the simulation start at zero time, all these block will be executed. But whatever is written inside this always block, whatever the statement is written inside the always block, they are executed sequentially. So if this always block starts, then these statements are executed sequentially, and if this always block starts, this is executed sequentially. So inside the always block, the statements are executed sequentially, but all the three, I have included three always blocks, so all the three always blocks, they run simultaneously at zero simulation time, and it depends on the simulator. Means the simulator may start this always block first, then this always block or this always block. It depends on the simulator, but what we have to remember is inside the always block, they run sequentially, but inside the module, all the always block, they run parallelly. Okay, so this is all about the always block, that how the always block can be used for combinational circuit, then sequential circuit, then if you do not mention any sensitivity list, then it runs continuously, and if there is a changes in sensitivity list, then the always block is activated, and whatever inside the statements we write inside the always block, that will be evaluated. Okay, so this is all about always block, and hope you understood something, you learned something, and if you enjoyed this tutorial, then you can like this one. You can also subscribe this channel for more update, and thank you so much for watching.